spend more of our time in looking at Christ, we should soon fix ourselves. He tells us fixing our eyes on Christ is the first step and the entire path of the Christian life. You know, think about the examples in life that you find where we fix our eyes on something. How about the batter at home plate watching the pitcher? What does he have his eyes fixed on? He has his eyes fixed on that ball because he knows that unless he makes contact with that ball, he's going to be sitting on the bench pretty quick. What about when we're walking a path and we're getting a little bit tired? But in the distance, we see our destination. We see that restaurant where we can sit down and have that meal and get a little bit of rest. And so, in the midst of our tiredness, in the midst of our, I don't know if I can make it, we fix our eyes on that restaurant. And it gets us there. And that's what God tells us to do. It's really simple. Fix your eyes on me. You know what happens many, many times? I don't know why I'm going back here because I'm out of that already. How many times do we fix our eyes on our sin? And some of you may be going, well, wait a minute, we should be fixed. No, no. If we fix our eyes on our sin, we cannot see Christ. Christ says, fix your eyes on me and your sin will be taken care of. Yeah. Walk with me and your sin will be taken care of. Don't look at that. How many times do we try and fix ourselves? I do daily. My wife does minute by minute. But only God can fix us. Only God can make things right. Keep your eyes on Jesus. It's just that simple. How many times have we talked before about God's message is so simple, and all we do is try and complicate it. All we do is talk more and more and more and more when we need to just listen more and more and more and speak less. So that's my message this morning. I'm going to stop right there. I'm not even going to go any further. Fix your eyes on Jesus and all will be well. This next song that we're going to sing, the pastor